If we were visiting the world's first paranormal petting zoo, would you want to play with the unicorn or give the psychic cat a ball of yarn in exchange for wishes?
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Tech with Sach. My name is Sachin, a Google developer expert, and in this video, we'll be building an action for the Google Assistant from start to finish with no coding involved in less than 5 minutes using the actions template. Without further ado, let's get started. So the first step is to go to console.actions.google.com. From there, you'd be taken to the welcome screen on Actions on Google. So Actions on Google is a developer platform where you can extend the functionalities of the Google Assistant. So the next step would be to go and click on New Project. Agree to the terms and conditions and give a project name of your choice. So once you click on create project, this would create an Actions on Google project ID and go ahead and click on templates. So for this episode, we'll be focusing on personality quest 2 template. Click on that, which would take you to this section where you can click get started. Click on the Personality Quiz 2 template, which should open up a Google Sheet where you can actually make a copy of that template. So this Google Sheet provides you with all the options that's necessary for you to make sure that your actions are configured directly into the Google Sheet. Give a name for your Google Sheet. And let's explore some of the options. So the template offers a quiz intro, Q&A, outcomes, settings, general prompts. The intro section is where the first thing that your action response bracket or your greetings from the action would be under the intro section. So you can have 3 or 4 responses, random responses that you would like your action to respond on each of those. So let's go ahead and click on all of these tabs and explore more. So this is the quiz introductory part. You can go and make changes there. The next one is the quiz questions and answers tab. Again, here you can see you have personality trait, questions, positive and negative responses. So the questions is what the user would see while interacting with your action. And each of those questions has a positive response and a negative response. Now, depending on your positive and negative response, a specific trait would be associated with it. So let's say for that question, if your response was a positive, it would then go on to corresponding trait. The next one is the quiz outcomes. So based on the questions that you have answered, it will check where the traits fall under. If the traits fall under negative and all the 3 questions that you answered were under the negative trait, then that means the first outcome would be displayed or sent back to the user as a response. The quiz outcome is as simple as this. All you have to make sure that depending on your quiz template or action, you can go ahead and configure these. And finally, this is the place where you want to actually go and change some of these settings where you can customize. So let's say instead of start button, you want to make it to begin, you can do that. You can also go ahead and change the fonts, text color, background, give an intro title, subtitle. All of these can be mentioned over here. So all these options are available to you, so you can configure these. And finally, we have the general prompts. And few things to notice, you can see the gray, green, and yellow section throughout this template. The gray, do not touch those. The green, you can always feel free to touch those and make changes and configurations in it. And finally, you go and click on share. Once you click share, you get a get shareable link. Copy that specific link and go ahead and paste that specific link onto the Google Sheet URL. So click upload. So once we upload our Google Sheet, you can see that the action is ready. So let's go ahead and try our action in the simulator. So this will load up this Actions on Google Test Simulator, where you can test your action. And you can immediately see that our specific action that we built or just configured within 5 minutes is actually working right now in the Actions on Google Test Simulator.
Do you wish to answer a few questions?
So this specific template is actually powered by Interactive Canvas. So Interactive Canvas allows you to experience both visual as well as audio responses. So in this case, you can see that we have a visual display where you are actually being treated with information both in the form of voice as well as text. And you can interact with these buttons either by touch or depending on what you say, a specific a click event is triggered or a specific action is taken into effect.
Okay, last question. Suppose that we lived in a log cabin in the middle of nowhere with only a wood stove for warmth. How would you rather chop wood, all at once or little by little, every day? I have your result. This is exciting.
So based on all of these questions and answers that you have provided, it will check the template and identify that based on these responses, either being positive or negative responses, it will associate a trait with it, personality trait. And based on that specific personality trait is then an outcome being decided. So you can go ahead and make changes to this template as per your requirements, build your own personality quiz, and then immediately upload it to your Actions on Google console. You can also go ahead and submit it for review. This would be a much more faster process because you're actually using a template, and you can have your action submitted and deployed, and anyone who's having access to Google Assistant can trigger your action. So the final step is, if you'd like to see this directly onto your device, go ahead to Activity Controls and enable the Include Voice and Audio Recordings. Finally, you can actually go ahead and check this entire experience directly onto your own device, either on your Android phone or your own Google Home Hub or Nest device, by saying, "Hey Google, talk to my test app." And this would immediately trigger your action and you can see it live working onto your device. And the next step would be to go ahead and deploy this action directly on the Actions on Google console, where your action, once it is approved, would be available to all. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section what you built, and the best actions out there will be highlighted in the upcoming events as well. So looking forward to see what you guys build, and see you guys in the next one.
Hey, hope you all enjoyed the video. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel. This is wonderful. I am really eager to see what you build for me. Take care, stay safe, and see you all in the next one.